Hey guys, welcome back to another video with Tony's Phone Collection. Today we're going to do some more unboxings and some phones I picked up. I do have a good amount of phone lots that I've gotten, so we'll start with this one here. I feel like it's just easier if I buy a whole bunch, to be honest, and then do like an unboxing at the end of the week or something like that, I think, right now. So that's kind of what I've been doing. There's those, so that. First up is a battery. Looks a little bloated, but I didn't realize it came with it, but we'll take it. We've got a charger, micro USB to USB-A, and then a travel charger adapter. There we go. I always call them charging bricks. So here's the first one, LG Chocolate 3. I already have one of these, to be honest, but I didn't have one with the box. So here's the phone. Seems to be dead. I don't really like cases, so I'll usually just throw them in a bin I have that I just put all my phone cases in. They're just, I don't know, I just don't like them. Kind of a pain to get to. Let me see if I can get this one off. There's the top piece. So it looks like it still has the original cover on the display. Let's slide this over a little bit and then let's see if we can get the bottom piece off here. There's the bottom piece. So this phone's probably in really good shape, to be honest, now that we got the case off of it. Looks to be in really good shape. Let's see. No SD card. Does have a battery, which is extremely bloated and squishy, so that's probably why it has no charge. We'll move on to the next one. LG Dare. Pretty common phone through the time, to be honest with you. I don't remember what I paid for these, but it wasn't too bad, to be honest. I'm gonna set those over here real quick. So here's this one. This is just a silicone case. It's in pretty good shape as well. It does have a screen protector on it also. I'm guessing it is probably dead. The headphone jack cover is that gooey stuff too. And it is dead. No SD card either. No. Oh yeah, it does. 2 gigabyte. There we go. Pop the back cover off here. Does have a replacement battery, it looks like. Made in China. There's that. We'll move on to the next one here. Dropped it. There's one here. So here we go. This is a LG G2 on Sprint. I think on the listing, I think they said the touchscreen doesn't work. But it is in really good shape, and I figured I could probably get a new screen for it. Pretty cheap, to be honest. Got the SIM card tray here, it looks like. It is on Sprint.
Before activation, you can turn on the TalkBack voice navigation feature for the visually impaired. Double tap the center of your screen to activate this feature. To enable other features, tap accessibility settings. To continue activation, press next.
There's that one, I guess. I guess some of the screen works, but not the rest of it.
Before activation, so. You can turn on the TalkBack voice there's navigation that, I guess. Feature for the visually impaired. Double tap the
and
center of your screen to activate this feature. To
can't
enable
turn
other
it off either.
Features, tap accessibility settings. To continue activation, press next.
Okay. We'll go ahead and grab this one here. I hate these ones with those blue tabs because they're really on there, to be honest with you. I'm going to have to edit out my address on there, it looks like. There's that. Let's see here.
Voice navigation turn back on. Feature for the visually impaired. Double tap the center of your screen to activate this feature. To enable other features, tap accessibility settings. To continue activation,
well,
press next.
We'll just set that one over there and hopefully it doesn't make another sound. Let's see here. Give me 1 second. Alrighty, I think that one's taken care of. So here's this one. Seems on there pretty good, to be honest. I don't know who packed this one, but they didn't want to go anywhere. So this one is a I remember ordering this one. It's a pretty interesting phone. It's a V60 series. But it's a kind of like the Mercedes phone and stuff like that. It's actually in a Audi or Audi, whichever way you want to say it, branded device. I don't know if it works or not. I don't think it was tested, so I'll probably have to plug it in and see if it gets anywhere, but there it is. Let's take a look at the battery, see what it looks like. Definitely bloated as well. So probably gonna need a battery. A little squishy. Model number 60C. So there's that one. Set that battery to the side. Start with the next one. This is a Motorola with a decent looking battery. Model number W233 on T-Mobile. Does have a cable with it, which there's the charging port there. It is missing the flap. Let's see, no power, so it's probably, oh, there we go. About to say it's probably dead. There, let's look at this real quick again. It is about to die, but there you go, it does work, and it died. So we'll move on to some of these bigger foam lock ones here. And like I said, I usually open these upside down so I don't have to cover the label up because I'm kind of lazy and there's a lot of them. So if I just open them up upside down, I don't have to really worry about it. So definitely an interesting way of packaging these ones here. So there's a phone in here. There's one here, taped up. This one is extremely sticky on the back, I can already feel it. Yeah, I love the Motorola Soft Touch. Rocker Z6. Now, a lot of other phones use the Soft Touch stuff, but Motorola seems to be the most common one. Looks to be in really good shape. It's got the blue keyboard. I think the one I have is a like a pink or red color, I think, if I remember right. I think it's the maybe the, like the Z3 or something. I don't remember which one it was, but there's that one here. No power. We'll turn that one upside down because it's sticky. There's two more here. Here is another Motorola. This is like a blue color on the back. Battery a little bloated, maybe, but not bad. Motorola A956 on the model number on this one. It might be an extended battery or something. I don't know. This looks kind of different. It's probably dead as well, if I'm guessing. Indeed, it is. I'll set that one over here with the other one. I had one of these before, and I think it was a clone, if I remember right. So I ended up sending it to RetroComms. I told her she could have it, or I think I'm supposed to send it. I don't remember. But I didn't like it, so I ended up sending it to her. Here is this one. Let's take a look if it's cheap and kind of aftermarket feeling, because it's usually how it goes. Well, here's a battery. It has another battery. This one is stamped engineering sample for product development and or for product development purposes only. Let's see if the phone says anything about that. No, it just looks to maybe be the battery. I don't know. Those look like a normal sticker to me. I don't know why it's upside down, but it looks kind of normal to me. The phone itself, I don't know, it feels a lot better than the other one. Definitely feels a little bit better built. I don't know. Keypad looks so different. I'll have to turn it on. I don't know, they all just seem the same though. Like, it doesn't really matter if it's a original one or a replica. They all feel the same to me. Like, on some areas, the hinge feels like a normal one. I know on the other one, the screen didn't feel right when you run your finger around the edge, like it'd be lifted in like one corner or the other. This one feels pretty good. It doesn't creak like the other one does. I don't know, we'll have to look at it. If anyone knows, let me know in the comments. I do read comments, as you guys know. I answer as many of them as I can. I try to answer every comment, to be honest, but sometimes I do miss them. nothing against anybody. There's another one here. Let's just set these out, I guess. That looks to be it in that box. So starting off with this one, screen's in really rough shape, extremely scratched. AT&T, it's got the original AT&T SIM card in it. This one does rattle, I noticed, though. Let me see if I can put this on here. Not sure, no battery either in this one. Here is another Sanyo device, which I already have one of these, but I cannot get mine to turn on. SCP-5300. Except I do have one of these, but mine does not work, and the hinge is cracked right here. This one looks to be a little rough, but hopefully with the new battery I have and the other battery, I can get it to turn on, because that'd be nice to have one of these working. So there's that one. That's the reason I bought this lot, was because of that phone. This little fellow's missing an antenna, it looks like. SCP-5500. It's got a different colored battery. The camera's on the back, which is kind of different. It's got a flash up here, it looks like. Like I said, missing antenna. Probably have enough Sanyo phones that I could probably get an antenna to fit on it, to be honest with you. No power either. Here is a BlackBerry battery that came with it. Another case. Throw that in the bin. This one is a SCP-5000. These are all, so far, Sprint phones here. And then AT&T, like I said, with the SIM card. This one shows no power either. I think it's just maybe some on here. I might be able to clean all of this up on this one and this one. I'll have to see what I can do. Headphone cover's missing. Probably got brittle and broke off. They usually, for the most part, do on these whenever you flip them. I've got a couple of them, so. There's that one there. And then last is a Nokia 5190. It's got a SIM card in it. Let's see what we got. Voice stream. If I can put that in there, maybe. Like I said, probably doesn't have any charge on this one at all, if I'm guessing. I don't know what that thing is there for. Oh, it's the release for the keypad cover, it looks like. It has no power as well, but there's those ones. And we do have one more box here. Let me pause this just real quick. So here we go. This one's gonna be kind of a big box to work around. So what I'm gonna do is kind of move some of these phones over here now. And I'm just gonna kind of set them over here on the side as we open them, because there's a lot in this one. Believe it or not, I only paid a dollar for this lot, $1.25 I think it was. I bid on it. I'll see if I can pull up the listing here. It was as is, obviously. I bid on it. I'll cover the seller's information. $1.25, and it was $14.90 in shipping. So let's take a look and see what we got. Here is the first one, Nokia 6120. Phone is in there, card charger it looks like. Let me slide this over some more to give us some more room real quick here. There we go. 6120i doesn't seem to have a carrier branding or anything on it. Doesn't have to show to have any power either. There's that. There's some books and stuff that goes with it. It seems to be an unbranded box. No carrier or anything. I'll see if there's some optional accessories. Trying to see if there's carrier branding. Nothing on that box. The next one is a Kyocera 1135 on cellular one. There's a phone, car charger, and a wall plug. Let's go and pull the phone out of the holster here. It's probably going to be dead as well. Got a battery there. There's the model and stuff on it. There's that one. Let's see. Here's a bunch of chargers. Probably not going to pull those out. Oh, my bad. Smack the tripod here. All seems to be chargers and one battery I see in there, I thought. Yeah, there is a battery here. Motorola battery, it looks like. There's that. That seems to be the only thing in there is chargers, and we've got enough of those out already, so we'll leave those in there. Here's another package. More chargers. Toss them to the side. Another charger. And here we got a phone here. This is a LG Chocolate VX8500. Has a charger. Screen's pretty rough shape. These plastic ones always scratch like that too. I don't know. It's just a common thing for them. Chrome is coming off the sides. Pretty common being plastic. Battery's a little bulged up. Not bad. Water indicator is red on the battery. The phone one is good. Let's see if there is an SD card. No SD card in this one. We'll go ahead and set this to the side. Here we got a Verizon bag. Which we'll try to keep that, because that's kind of cool. Book for a Nokia 100, Motorola Time Port. There is a screen protector for something. Kind of looks like an iPhone, probably is. Here's some of them there. So let's start off with these ones here. Samsung SCH-R500, if I remember right. Yep, R500, SCH, Alltel device. I think it's the Samsung Hue, if I remember right. Probably dead. Looks to be in good shape though. Got a red front plate with the blue back, which there is a couple more here. Here is a the original back for that one and the faceplate for this, so either way you want to look at it. Both dead. guessing neither have SD cards, maybe. Let's see. No SD card in the blue front. This one does. It has a, I've never seen that before, a no-name card. It looks like it's actually just a spacer. That's kind of crazy. I can't get my camera to focus either. There we go, I'll do that. No name, no contacts, no nothing, so it's just a blank. I didn't even know they made those, but apparently they do. So there's both of those. Both have the charging port flaps. They both have batteries. And then there's also this one here. This is a sticky one. I don't know if it's a cover. Looks like it is. Dead as well, probably. Battery in there as well. No SD card slot in this one. No SD card in that one. Here we have a OtterBox case. Guessing probably for this iPhone 5C. Or maybe it's just a 5. Here's an iPhone 5C in green. Screen looks to be in decent shape. Oh, maybe not. It's got a little chip here in the corner. Right there it is. Got a few scratches up here at the top. No power, obviously. Probably dead. We'll take a look at that. Probably got the original faceplate for the yellow one, which this one's still got the wrapper on it. And this one looks to be brand new too. A little dirty. This is that Motorola time port. There's the information there. A83. I don't know where the model number is on these, to be honest with you. A lot of stuff there so you guys can see. It is obviously going to be dead. There is a LG VX6100. It is on Verizon. Screen is like delaminating there on the corner. That's kind of different. Is dead. Got some pretty heavy wear on this keypad. Pretty heavy wear on the front. Does still have the cover for the camera. I would say in average shape, to be honest. Definitely looks a little rough, but I have seen worse. Samsung Convoy, if I remember right. Does have a battery, model number SCH-U640. Let's see if I can get this cover back on. No SD card slot, or no SD card in there. Proprietary Samsung charger, as always. Screen looks good. No power. Here's a blue cover and faceplate also. LG 235C. I'm guessing maybe on track phone, something like that. We'll see here in a second. No SD card slot on this one. Is on track phone. Probably gonna be dead. Pretty decent shape on this one. Another Motorola time port. And then we have a Nokia 252P. I guess there's a CTIA seal. I don't know. There it is in the corner. Maybe you guys tell me about that. Maybe it's just showing it's an original Nokia product. I don't know. It is dead as well. Especially with these batteries, I'm not surprised. All these nickel batteries are usually dead. And then we have a Samsung, I guess an SCH model number. R631. took a chance on this one, hoping it's an Alto branded phone. Alto one's really hard to tell, so I figured for, I guess, almost 15 bucks, it was worth a chance. So there's that one. Seems to be in decent shape screen. It does have a screen protector on it also. I'm guessing it's dead as well. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. That was longer than I was thinking. And stay tuned for the next one.